So Donald Trump's impeachment trial is starting today, and on the foundation of his lawyer's case, there is a massive, gigantic whopper of a lie, which is that Donald Trump was quote-unquote horrified by what he saw on January 6th, that he didn't condone it, he didn't incite it, he didn't plan it, he didn't want it, and that when it was happening, he was watching on television, horrified, wanting to stop it. And that is a lie. 100%. We've covered it on this channel. I don't need to get into the details. There's a good Washington Post piece that sort of does a sort of relative minute-to-minute breakdown about what happened that day, sort of as a rebuttal to these legal claims by Trump's team. But we have to make it very clear that in general, and here's a good quote from the piece, it says, people in contact with the president that day have said Trump was initially pleased to see a halt in the counting of electoral votes, reluctantly issued calls for peace after first ignoring entreaties to do so. What happened that day is Trump sicked his thugs on the Capitol and then went home to the White House and watched it gleefully on TV. People around him, other officials tried to get him to dissuade them, call in reinforcements, whatever he could do, you know, in an official sense and in a rhetorical sense to calm stuff down, and he initially refused. Remember, on that same day, Melania Trump, his wife, refused to even stop her photo shoot. The Trump supporters loved what was happening that day. They absolutely loved it, and that includes the Trump family and Trump himself. We remember after they basically pulled his nails, they got Trump to record that video, which was him saying, you know, this is not appropriate. We're the party of law and order. We love the police. We love following procedure. You know, you should all go home. But he said, I love you. You're special. You're great. I understand why you're mad. Basically saying to them, look, they forced me to record this video. They forced me to do it. But I actually don't believe it. I don't believe it. And then there were stories afterwards about how Donald Trump regretted recording that video. Regretted doing it. Because he felt that it made him look weak or that he didn't believe in what he was saying. And as the reporting notes, he did no fewer than 3 takes. And that was the best one. So the other ones likely were even more unhinged. He might have even said, you know, keep doing what you're doing. He might have said, yeah, go home, I guess, but, you know, be nice to the police. Or he might have said, you know, follow law and order, but I support your right to protest here. Who knows? What I know is Donald Trump showed no remorse. And look, the trial is going to be based on a lot of evidence. They're going to try to argue that it's unconstitutional. They're going to try to say that Trump didn't mean what he said or what he said was misinterpreted. But fundamentally, there's one truth here, is that Donald Trump, at the very least, liked what he saw. Even if you think Donald Trump isn't guilty on the charges of impeachment, even if you think that, and there are going to be some that think that, you cannot deny that every piece of evidence we have from within his White House, from his own most loyal, closest staff, is that he was watching it on TV, seeing democracy and Congress attacked, and a police officer losing his life, and Trump loved it. That's all the evidence I need.